All right, let's stay with money. And the leadership of the National Assembly bulldozed its way to ensure passage of President Uhuru Kenyatta's amendments to the controversial Finance Bill 2018. During the morning session, members passed the supplementary appropriation bill that included some austerity measures that were opposed by a section of members. Speaker of the National Assembly, Justin Muturi, took charge of the committee of the whole house in a chaotic afternoon session. Let's bring in Patrick Amimo, who witnessed this conversation that happened in the morning. Patrick, good evening. We're looking at the austerity measures that are being discussed, that were discussed by members of parliament in the morning in a bid to reduce the expenditure by the national government. What stood out for you in the morning?
The morning session was equally charged, but now not as the afternoon session, which members were awaiting that presidential memorandum to exercise their muscles and see whether they'll overturn it and or not. But in the morning, what happened was that there was that matter touching on the CDF. The president's memorandum had wanted the CDF allocation to the CDF kitty reduced by 5.5 billion shillings. It is a matter that the Budget and Appropriations Committee looked into and said no to, and instead they reduced that CDF kitty by 2.4 billion shillings. This means that each constituency now will get 110 million shillings annually, as opposed to 118 million shillings that it was supposed to get before the budget was reviewed. The other matter that members were concerned that was touched was to do with the equalization fund and affirmative action and social development fund, where the government was looking at the government has proposed that the 2 billion shillings be slashed into this money, but the Budget and Proposals Committee said that that will not be possible, and instead the affirmative action was given 2.1 billion shillings, a matter that was saluted by those women representatives who are the people who manage this particular affirmative action fund. The other money that was to do with the laptop project, they chopped off 5 billion shillings. Remember, Jubilee administration came on board in 2013. They promised Kenyans that each school, by 2014, each primary school-going child was to get to have a laptop. It's a dream that has never been realized, and we are seeing instead that in its second term, they are cutting off this money that was meant for the laptop project, which ended up being tablets instead of laptops. So they've already chopped up 5 billion shillings into that. The other area that suffered a cut was the equalization fund, where the government decided that they reduced the equalization fund by 3.8 billion shillings. Remember, this was money that was meant in the constitution. It's meant to benefit those 14 counties that were marginalized since independence to come up to speed with the rest of the country, and the constitution had given these counties 20 years. So what we've seen with the Jubilee administration is that they've kept on reducing money meant for the equalization fund, a matter that means that these counties will not go through. And again, also the Konza city was denied 400 million shillings, which means that idea on Konza city ICT will suffer. And also there was an idea on that 1 mile electricity connectivity, it was reduced by 1 billion shillings. So that connectivity, the electricity in the villages is expected to go down. So it's a matter that members canvass and express their views about it, saying that they don't accept it, despite the fact that even now that the punitive measures, some of these hidden taxes have been put on especially that touching on kerosene. It means kerosene will retail at par with diesel. This means that we'll see more of those households that depend on kerosene maybe now go to forests and start using firewood, because there was a proposal that LPG gas be provided, but that provision was cut out of this particular provision. So maybe we'll see as the price of kerosene shoots up, our forests are under threat. But now, let's listen to some of the members' of contributions on the floor with regard to those taxation measures that even touched on foreign travel, domestic travel, and hospitality.
It would be unreasonable to hit the budget that affects Kenyans. Kenyans outside there, for instance, when it comes to education, they solely depend on government and CDF for building of infrastructure in the schools. So when you attack it, then it means that you are not within the listening of the Kenyans. Honorable Speaker, I also saw the budget of the Teacher Service Commission affected. This country is lacking insofar as teachers' employment is concerned. And therefore, why would we go a step further to hit on areas that are required. And therefore, Mr. Speaker, I think that the proposals before us are not good for Kenyans. And moving forward, I would also want to tell the House that I'm not happy when the leadership within the House directs the motion on these budget allocations and proposals to mean that if the House and the members' interests have been taken care of, then we can leave the rest of the Kenyans to suffer with the taxes. That impression was very, very wrong, because outside there it will look like immediately we got what we thought was correct in terms of the CDF, in terms of other emoluments, then we left the ordinary Mwananchi to suffer.